So students, let's start with the today lecture. That is, our class is 11th class mathematics, 11th math. We are doing set chapter. So today we are going to discuss operations of, or you can say on sets. Okay, so as I have given small introduction, we are going to discuss the operations union, number two intersection, number three difference, number four symmetric difference, number five complement. So I will try to discuss these very four today, and complement we will discuss in the later stage. If I have a time today, then we will discuss, otherwise we will discuss in the next lecture. So these four operations that we are going to discuss, so this operation is not given in the NCERT. So it is very much important also, but it is not in the NCERT. So let's, what is a first thing you must know, what is the meaning of operations? Like I will take example, you have a two number like 2 plus 3. So this plus sign is the operation here when you have a number. Okay, if you have a number 2 and 3, these known as operands. आप लोगों ने कंप्यूटर के अंदर बाइनरी ऑपरेशन किया होगा, बुलियन किया होगा. इन दैट केस वी आर यूज टू से दैट दीज आर द ऑपरेंड्स एंड दिस इज द ऑपरेटर. करेक्ट, ऑपरेटर इज आल्सो नोन एज ऑपरेशन. बट व्हेन वी हैव ए मैट्रिक्स, सॉरी व्हेन वी हैव ए सेट्स, देन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ ऑपरेशन वी कैन अप्लाई. अदरवाइज वी नो दैट वी हैव ए प्लस, वी हैव माइनस, वी हैव ए मल्टीप्लीकेशन, वी हैव ए डिविजन, दीज काइंड ऑफ ऑपरेशन. But in case of sets, we have these kind of operation. Union is there, intersection is there, difference is there, symmetric difference is there, complement. So I will start with the union. What is the meaning of union? The first operation. Correct. So the symbol is, its symbol is small u. Capital U, I told you in the previous lecture, it is the universal set. Correct. So small u, how, what is the meaning? You will write like A union B. Okay, so you will read as this, you will read as A union B. So what is the meaning of this? If I will write in the this A union B, in particularly, particularly in set builder form, then you will write it contain all x. Okay, x belongs to A or x belongs to B. So this is very, very important. Or, what is the meaning of or? Either x is belongs to A or belongs to B or belongs to both. So I will try to discuss with the example. Let A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, only 3, and B is equal to 2, 3, 4. Now I am going to write A union B. So you will take all the element of A also and all the element of B also. But if some element is repeated, you will write only once. So you have A union B 1, 2, 3, 4 only. No, here 2 is repeated 2 times, but I am writing only once. Because you know that in a set, that element cannot be repeat. So therefore, this is the union. Now, students, I am going to show this union in the Venn diagram. I told you the Venn diagram is the graphically representation of a sets diagram. I will try to understand by try to explain with the help of Venn diagram also. Venn diagram. Okay, so see, let us suppose this is a universal set, universal. So here you have a A and here you have a B. So what is A union B? What is A union B? It will be B also, common part also, and A also. So you can write here, means A union B is equal to this. Correct? So means it cover the A part also, B part also, over, means overall everything. Correct? So let's start with the second operation. Second operation is intersection. So symbol of intersection is the ulta U, reverse, in reverse order. So how you will write it? A intersection B. So what is the definition of A intersection B? It contains all X. X belongs to A and is important. X belongs to B. Means A intersection B, here in the union you have a OR. In the intersection you have a AND. AND means you will take only those elements in A intersection B which are common to A and B both. If you have a same example like A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and B is equal to 2, 3, 4, then A intersection B will be 2, 3 because 2 and 3 are common. Okay, so if you will, you want to write its Venn diagram, I will write like this. So this, okay. So even you can write like this. How you will write? You can take another universal set. You can take A here. You can take B here. So this one is the intersection. So you can write A intersection B is equal to, so you can show like this, it is of this kind. Correct? Now here I have given the example 2, 3. Correct? Now see, what is the next? The next is the difference. Third is the difference. Correct? So difference is, it is a normal minus, it will be written as A minus B. So very important thing is here, A minus B will be, it contain all X. X belongs to A and X does not belongs to B. Now, means A minus B contain all the element of A which are not the element of B. So it is very interesting to see the example, like you have A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and B is equal to 3, 4, 5. Then see, what are the common elements between A and B? Only 3 is common. So when you will write A minus B, you will delete those elements from A because A is the main. You are subtracting B from A, and whatever the common element of A that is common to B, you will delete it. Similarly, you can find the value of B minus A. So B minus A will be, you will take all the element of B which are not the element of A. So you have a 4 and 5 only. Correct? A minus B. If you want to show this in the Venn diagram, so Venn diagram of this will be, this is A, this is B. So what you have here, this is the A minus B and this one is the this one is the a minus b, means you will take the element of a only, which are not the element of b, and this is b minus a. Correct? I hope you understand. So next is the symmetric difference. Very, very important. Symmetric difference. So symmetric difference symbol is like capital delta. Small delta is symbol is this. Okay. So this the symbol of, this is the symbol of symmetric difference. You will write A symmetric difference B. What is the meaning of that? It is a union of A minus B and B minus A. Correct? So see, union, you know that, you have discussed earlier, means if you have, this is the A minus B, this is B minus A, then A union B, asymmetric difference will be the collection of all these elements excluding this. Now another way, you can take A union B, means A union B is whole AB, and so you will subtract A intersection B from that. It is the another form of the A symmetric difference B. Means either you can write like this or you can write like this. Okay, students? So see, now let us take the example. You have a minus B here. Same example we will discuss here. A minus B is here. B minus A is here. Then A symmetric difference B will be A minus B. What is A? Union. Union of A minus B. What is A minus B? Is 1, 2. Union. What is B minus A? 4, 5. And what will be its union? Union will be 1, 2, 4, 5. Now, if you want to check by like this, first you find A union B. What is A union B? Is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is A intersection B? A intersection B is, what is common in A and B is 3. 3 only. So you, when you will subtract this from this, you will subtract 3, you will get this one only. Correct? So this is the symmetric difference. I hope you understand. Now the last one is the, fifth one is the complement. So it is written as, if you have any set A, it is written as a dash or AC. It is a complement of A. What is the meaning of that? Meaning of that, if you will write the definition, it contains all X. X must not be the part of, does not belong to A. Means you will take all X other than A. So your question may be, अगर हम A के एलिमेंट नहीं लेंगे तो फिर कौन से लेंगे बाहर? तो कोई हद होनी चाहिए कहां तक एलिमेंट लेने हैं. तो जो कॉम्प्लीमेंट है, वाई इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर ऑपरेशन, बिकॉज अगर मैं बोलूंगा कि A के एलिमेंट मैंने, लेट अस सपोज यू हैव A इज इक्वल टू 1 2, अगर मैं 1 2 को नहीं ले रहा तो कौन से लूंगा? दैट्स वाई यूनिवर्सल सेट इज रिक्वायर्ड. सो if you want to find out a complement, then you must know the universal. Why? Because its another definition is, you will find universal minus A. Means if you will take the Venn diagram, this is a universal set, contain everything. If A is there, then A minus B will be all the elements in universal other than A. Correct? So that's why universal is required. If you don't know the universal, you cannot find the A complement. So let us suppose universal, here I am taking 1, 2, 3, 4. So then A complement will be 1, 2 ke chhod ke jitne element hain, 3 and 4. Let's discuss the properties of the operation. Union. तो union operations की जो properties हैं, वो क्या कह रहा है। नाउ द फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टीज इज द ए यूनियन बी इज ऑलवेज इज इक्वल टू बी यूनियन ए। दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रॉपर्टी इज नाउन एज कम्यूटेटिव लॉ। करेक्ट। नाउ दिस इज द फर्स्ट लॉ कम्यूटेटिव लॉ। द सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द यूनियन इज एसोसिएटिव लॉ। What is associative law? Means A union B, if you will take the union of A, B first, then you will take the union with C, will be is equal to, if you will take the union of B, B and C first, then you will take the union with C, this will be equal. It is known as associative law. Now the third is very useful. Everybody must know the phi. This is the empty set. If you have A is any set, if you will take the union with phi, then result will be A only. Because phi do not have any element, then union with A will be A itself. Correct? And this particular law is known as identity. Identity law, and this phi will work as identity of union. Correct. So what is the meaning of identity? Identity एक तरह का ऐसा element होता है जिसको अब union की बात कर रहे हैं operation। जैसे मैं आपको example देता हूं, मुझे बताओ कोई भी एक number लो, उसमें एक ऐसा नंबर है कोई जिससे ए से मल्टीप्लाई करें तो ए आ जाए। यस वी हैव ए वन। तो वन एक ऐसा नंबर है जिसको किसी भी नंबर से मल्टीप्लाई करो वो नंबर वही रहता है, तो इसको आइडेंटिटी बोलते हैं। दिस इज द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ किस विच ऑपरेशन? मल्टीप्लीकेशन। दिस इज द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन। अब मेरे को बताओ कोई ऐसा एलिमेंट है जिसको ए में एड करें और रिजल्ट ए ही आ जाए, तो वो है जीरो। तो जीरो इज द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ प्लस। तो इसी तरह फाई एक ऐसा है कि आप ए के साथ यूनियन लो फाई को, रिजल्ट विल बी ए ओनली, सेम एलिमेंट, देन फाई विल वर्क एज आइडेंटिटी ऑफ यूनिवर्स। लेट्स टेक, इफ यू वांट टू नो अबाउट लाइक ए, ए यू हैव ए वन टू, वन टू है ना, बी यू हैव ए टू थ्री एंड सी यू हैव ए थ्री फोर। सो इफ यू विल टेक द ए यूनियन बी फर्स्ट, सो वट विल बी ए यूनियन बी? ए यूनियन बी विल बी वन टू थ्री, and then you will take A union B, then union with C, it will be 1, 2, 3 and 4 also, 1, 2, 3 and 4 also. Now you take first B union C, because you have to solve bracket first, so pahle aap B aur C ka le lo. Agar aap B union C le lete ho, to what you will get? You are getting here B aur C ka union kya hoga? 2, 3 and 4. Agar uske baad aap A ke saath union lete ho uska, so what you will get? You will get 1, 2, 3 and 4. So what you are getting? You are getting same thing. Correct? Fourth property is the idempotent law. It is also very common. It is known as idempotent. What is that? A union A will be A. It is known as idempotent law. Means it is very easy. Let us suppose A is equal to 1, 2. If you will take the union of A with A, so with both two elements, result will be A only. Correct? So this law is known as idempotent law. Correct? Now, very interesting. Fifth one. This is the universal. Universal, not union. Universal. Union with A will be the universal. बिकॉज यूनिवर्सल तो सबसे बड़ा सेट होता है, उसके अंदर ए है। अगर ए और इसका दोनों का यूनिवर्सल लोगे तो ये तो सारा ही आ जाएगा ना। सो दिस इज नोन एज लॉ ऑफ यूनिवर्सल। करेक्ट। सो दीज आर द लॉज प्रॉपर्टीज। नाउ प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन। So properties of intersection. Number one property, same commutative A intersection B will be is equal to B intersection A. Okay, this is the commutative law. Second, A intersection B, intersection C, or you can take B intersection C, then with A, result will be equal. It is associative law. Means associative law or commutative law both holds in both intersection and union. Now third property is, if you have a phi is the empty set, if you will take the intersection with A, any other set, then result will be phi. Very easy, because what is the meaning of intersection? We are going to take the common element. दोनों में कॉमन तो कुछ है ही नहीं, क्योंकि फाई के अंदर कोई एलिमेंट नहीं होता, तो रिजल्ट में फाई आएगा. दूसरा, यूनियन यूनिवर्सल सेट को हम इंटरसेक्शन लेते हैं ए के साथ, यू विल गेट ए, बिकॉज यूनी ए इज ए पार्ट ऑफ ए यूनिवर्सल सेट. तो दोनों में कॉमन क्या है? ए. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, करेक्ट. सो नीड नॉट टू नेम दिस लॉ, इट इज जस्ट ए रिजल्ट. फोर्थ, करेक्ट, आइडेम्पोटेंट इज हेयर ऑल्सो, A intersection B, sorry, A intersection A will be A. What is common between A and A? A only, correct. It is known as idempotent. Tenth law, is it okay? Now next, fifth one is the A intersection B union C. This is very very important law. Means here is the union, here is the intersection. So A intersection B union A intersection C. Let me explain this one. Like you know that you have a multiply B plus C, like we have a three number, not a sets, three number. तो क्या लिखोगे आप? ए को बी से मल्टीप्लाई करोगे, बीच में प्लस लिखोगे, तो ए को सी से मल्टीप्लाई करोगे. तो दिस इज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, आपने ए को बी और सी के साथ डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर दिया, करेक्ट. तो ये भी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन है, ए इंटरसेक्शन बी सी बिटवीन यूनियन ए इंटरसेक्शन सी, करेक्ट. हियर मींस दिस इज ऑल्सो एप्लीकेबल फॉर, इफ यू विल टेक union here and intersection inside, it will be A union B intersection A union C. Okay, but if you will interchange these two, this is not possible in other operation, but here is possible. Correct. This particular law is known as, yes, I have received your message. Okay, this known as distribution law, correct. So let's discuss now the properties of complement of a set. Okay. So the first is known as complement law. If you will take a union A of A union A complement, then it will be a universal law set. Very interesting. You have a A, this is the A, and this is the A complement. When you will join these both, you will get universal. So this is known as complement law. Second, A intersection A complement will be phi, because A complement or A ke beech mein kuch common nahi hai, then this na la ka bhi hum complement se hi bolte hain. Third law is de Morgan law, jo chai ne mujhe pucha tha. चैन को हमने ये वीडियो के अंदर अमर कर दिया है. ओके, सो डी मॉर्गन लॉ Mr. Chen, your answer is A union B complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Correct. If you want to check, I will check this one. This is very, very important law. So if you will take A union B complement, then it will be A complement intersection B complement. Correct. This is the De Morgan law. So before taking any other law, so let's discuss small example of De Morgan law. Okay, so let's now I have received your message. Okay, now see, so this is A, let us suppose you have A is equal to, I will take a very small example, 1 2, and B is 2 3. So you know that whenever you want to find the complement, you must need the universal. So I am taking universal 1, 2, 3, 4. I am just taking one element extra. So you tell me what will be the A complement. A complement will be except 1, 2, you have a 3, 4. What is a B complement? B complement kya hoga? 2, 3 ko chhod ke baki sare kitna? 1 and 4. Correct? So now first I will check this one. First I will find A union B. सबसे पहले मैं ये निकालूंगा, ए यूनियन बी क्या होगा, ए और यू यूनियन बी यूनियन क्या है, 1 2 एंड 3. नाउ आई विल फाइंड ए यूनियन बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो एक्सेप्ट दिस, व्हाट आर द रेस्ट, ओनली 4. सो लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ऑफ दिस इज 4. नाउ नदर दिस वन, ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट यू हैव दिस वन, बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट यू हैव दिस वन. सो इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ दिस A complement intersection B complement. What is common between these two set is 4. So now this is equal to this. So similarly you can verify this one. Correct? Means A complement over the complement is A again. This is very useful. And the last one is the, if you have a phi, what is a complement of phi? Universal. And another, what is the complement of universal? Is phi. बिकॉज फाइव में तो होता ही नहीं कुछ, सारा का सारा यूनिवर्सल ही होगा उसको छोड़ के. नाउ व्हाट इज द अदर, अगर हम यूनिवर्सल का कॉम्प्लीमेंट लें तो यूनिवर्सल तो सारा कुछ ही होता है, उसको छोड़ के क्या होगा, फाइव. सो दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिजल्ट्स. करेक्ट. सो दीज आर द सम इंपॉर्टेंट लॉ ऑफ द ऑपरेशंस. करेक्ट.